proceed on the matter of purification. And as usual, I remind you and I warn you that the advice here is only for seekers, and it is going to be extremely offensive to the ego. Those who are not spiritual seekers and those where the ego is dominant should not listen to this video. What we are in the eyes of the others is determined by our behavior, and our behavior is simply a manifestation of what we are internally. Behavior is external, it is seen, it is that which we do, it is the karma, it is the action. And as usual, because of the ignorance, a lot of impurities are seen in the behavior. So I'm going to give you a non-exhaustive list of these impurities just as an example, the most common ones. A general impurity is immorality. For our purpose, we can define it as any behavior that causes harm to others and to the self. Hopefully, everybody will agree on this definition. There are finer aspects of immorality, like don't do this, it is immoral, and don't do that, that is immoral. We should all do one specific thing because that is moral. These are mutually agreed upon set of behaviors, and people call them moral, immoral, and whatever they want. But any immorality from the point of view of a spiritual seeker is simply that which causes harm. It can be harm to the environment, to the animals, to the plants, to other people. It can be harmful towards the body or the relations. Any action. And you will find that it is a major impurity because we do not think twice before doing something. It is governed by selfishness. Everybody is ready to do whatever they want to do, to get whatever they want by any means. Whether it causes harm, whether it causes destruction, people don't care. There is darkness here. There is ignorance here. Some people are in immoral jobs, and some people are downright criminals. They're violent. I call them the impure jobs. If your job involves lying, if your job involves causing harm to the environment or to the animals, taking lives, promoting wars and promoting hate, or promoting greed, it does not matter how rich you are, it does not matter how much you are earning from that. This is an impurity. Some people will say, oh, everybody does that. I have no choice but to do it. Otherwise, I won't survive. Otherwise, I won't get that which others have. And this itself is an impurity. Thinking like this itself is an impurity. This points to a lot of confusion, ignorance, stupidity, indoctrination. If you are working for a company that is selling fake products to people, that is an impure job. If you are in a service which is simply about earning money and not really service, it is an impure job. And some good jobs can turn into impure jobs simply because the worker is impure. Like being a doctor is a good job, but if all you want is money from the patients, you keep them alive so that they keep paying you. You keep them sick because they are your bread and butter. Even though this is a very, very noble job, it has been turned into an impure job. Impure job does not mean unclean job. That is a different kind of impurity. That is related to the body. Here it is related to the behavior. If you are in a job where you are saving criminals, where you are asking for bribes, where you are ruling others, you're taking advantage of their weakness and inability. These all are impure jobs. If you're selling something which is very nice and required for the life, but you are selling at 10 times the cost, it is an impure job. It is an impure business. A job where you're exploiting people, not paying them properly, or people are working under you in bad conditions, it is an impure job. If your job is very violent, it involves killing people or animals or cutting trees, for example, or punishing people. The list is very long, and you will find that it is very hard to find a pure job these days. Why is job my behavior? Because that is what I do. If you ask anybody, who are you? And the first thing they will say is their name, and second thing they will say is their profession. That is how people are identified with their jobs, because that is what they do. If you are among people who are like this, you will automatically become jealous, competitive. You will generate a lot of unpleasantness in others. And also, you will face the unpleasantness of the behavior of the others. If you are doing your work normally, honestly, and somebody else is competing with you, he is doing whatever he can to make you fail or take your credit, you are in an impure job. It is unpleasant. If something gives rise to jealousy or some things are done out of jealousy, that is an impurity in the behavior. If the behavior is manipulative, all we want is things for myself. It is extreme selfishness. That shows up in the behavior, manipulative behavior. If somebody is rich, you lick his feet. It does not matter if he is a criminal or a politician. If you want somebody to do something for you, you are suddenly nice. As soon as the job is over, you show your real colors. This is manipulation. Almost everybody is fake. You must have seen this. They show a different face to the people than they actually are. They learn it very quickly. Even a child learns to fake the behavior. So they are smiling, they are very pleasant, they are talking a flowery language like butter polishing everybody. But as soon as you discover their real nature, it is mostly completely opposite. People are fake. A rich person does not really display his richness. He is in ordinary clothes, t-shirt and trousers, and eats simple food. Somebody who is incompetent, cannot earn, needs to show how rich they are. And you can see it on their face, in their behavior, in whatever they are showing off to be seen as rich. They are fake people. Similarly, people fake their love. They fake a relation and they fake their competence. Some people are experts in this. They can fake intelligence, for example, by throwing heavy words around. In spiritual circles, people throw spiritual words around so that everybody perceives them as spiritual. They understand nothing, but they have heard these big words, Sanskrit words from somewhere, and they simply fake it. There are fake gurus, which will be the extreme case of a fake seeker. Not only people are fake, there are entire companies that are fake. There are entire families that are fake. The families are taught to remain fake so that they get the social status. And there are entire cultures that are fake. There are countries that are totally fake. Their media, their governments, they just pose a very good picture of themselves. We have high values. We are very progressive, very rich, very civilized. And you visit that country and it is like hell. All kinds of greedy, immoral, violent people are residing in that country. Drug addicts, alcoholics, criminals. Their media shows a gold-coated image of that country. So, fakeness is human nature. Even monkeys do that. Some animals also do that. Faking beauty, we have seen that as an example of impure behavior. Look, I'm so beautiful. Wash off the makeup and there is nothing. A beautiful person need not fake anything. Look, I'm so beautiful because I'm wearing this $1 million clothing. No, the clothing is beautiful. You are ugly. You think nobody understands this? Everybody understands this and they're laughing at your back. When you fake things, you are fooling yourself, nobody else. We have the ability to fake and we have the ability to detect fakes. Only a very stupid and very retarded person will fall for your fakeness. You can show off for 1 day, 2 day, and then third day you are back to the original. It does not work. The next impurity is using others for your benefit. This can come very close to the manipulation. But here, the target is a particular person. A manipulative person is manipulative for everybody. If you are using somebody, it is usually your close relatives or friends. And it can take many forms. You use somebody to do your work or do whatever you want them to do for yourself, probably because they are dependent on you. A good example is parents. Because children are dependent on them, they use them in any way they want. A husband can use his wife in any way he wants because she is totally dependent on husband. an employer can use an employee. You don't need to manipulate them. You can simply use them. Tell them on their face that I am going to use you. Or you can fake it that I am good and keep using them. So it is a long-term thing with a specific person. Sometimes we behave conditionally. If you do good to me, I'll be good to you. Oh, you insulted me, I'll insult you. You're violent to me, I'll kill you. This is called conditional behavior. And you must have seen that everybody displays this behavior. Everybody. Seeker, no seeker. If you are respecting me, yes, I'll respect you. You can immediately see it is some kind of fakeness there. You don't have any original behavior left. It is always a reaction of some kind. Another impurity is asking for favors or looking for opportunities where you get something from other people and then you dance around them, be with them just because there is a chance that you will get something. This is a selfish behavior, greedy behavior. You know that your friend's mother cooks very delicious food and then you're found at his place again and again and again. This is an impure behavior. You know that one of your relatives is very rich and you try to gain the favors of that person. You know that your friend drinks a lot and you join him because you get free alcohol, free cigarettes, free drugs. You don't have to spend anything. You just give him company, he gives you everything. You're found in parties because you are very poor, you have nothing to eat. You become guests often. Why? Because they serve you food and drinks and so on. We do that a lot. If somebody is doing something for you, you're always ready. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you very much. You are so kind. This is an impure behavior. Somebody loves you, you never return that love. Somebody helped you, you never say thank you. You borrow things from people, you never return. Somebody pays you money for a job, you do bad work. Somebody is asking for help and you simply insult them. You kick them out. It is not immoral. This is not a manipulation. This is not fakeness. But it is impure behavior because it is unkind. This is not human behavior. Somebody is lost and he is asking for direction and you send him in the wrong way. Just because you can laugh afterwards. Bullying people. Showing of racial superiority. Discrimination. Because you belong to a specific caste or religion. All these things are unkind behavior. The list is very long. And finally, there are people who will always be negative. As soon as they meet you, they vomit negativity. Their behavior is negative. Their speech is negative. Even their expressions are negative. Something good happened to you and you meet this person and your day is going to be ruined. It is guaranteed. You achieve something. Oh no, it's nothing. This is not competition really. That person is not trying to compete. It's not jealous. Just negative. You are a little bit sick and that person shows up. Oh, you know this can be a big sickness. So many people die. You don't know what can happen. Highly toxic. Oh, I got a new job. You know that's not a good job. Have you checked that company? They are not good people. Probably they are illegal. And these people are negative. They enter the room and negativity enters. Positivity leaves. People become selfish. People become violent in their presence. Wherever they go, they cause failures. If your project is going good, this person joins the project, everything is gone down the drain. This is because of the impure behavior. The impurity is very, very deep here. Probably there is no cure for it. Now you know the impurities of the behavior. Here is your chance to identify the impurities and start correcting them. It is not difficult, really. Still, I'm going to give you some hints as usual. Use them if you can. Otherwise, you are wise enough to clean up your behavior. There is a formula here. There is an equation here that if you are impure inside, your behavior will be impure. And if you clean your behavior, the impurities inside you will start cleaning themselves. If you don't believe me, you can try it as an experiment. If you are pure inside, you start behaving badly and you will see that your mind also is impure now. Fight with somebody, even as a joke, and you will see that there is negativity in you now. Similarly, it does not matter how dirty you are inside, just start doing something good and you will notice that internal purification is happening. It does not matter how selfish you are lowest of the lowly, do one good thing, unconditionally help somebody one day just as an experiment, you will immediately find there is a refinement, there is a purification internally. Otherwise, we don't have any interest in purifying our behavior. There is no gain. The gain is overall. That is why we are interested. Plus, it makes your life very easy in the society. This is added benefit. Oh no, the society does not deserve good behavior. But don't worry. They will stop troubling you if your behavior is good enough. I'm not telling you to become a saint. Just 90% of it, if you can manage, you are done. Your job is done. Your purification is done. So find out which of your behavior is causing harm. Stop doing it. Turn to the next one and stop doing it. You may write it down if you like, because you forget very easily. In your diary, write down that this is the kind of behavior that comes under impurities. And I need to fix it. I need to let go of this. I need to behave differently in that situation. Keep your awareness on. Keep your intelligence on. Delay the action at least for 24 hours before you act on any decision. Take your decisions carefully. Consult a wise man. Consult your guru before you act. Don't do it. I've seen that if you delay your action even by 5 minutes, it has great consequences. Most of the immoral behavior is mostly habit. It's an indoctrination that came from outside. It's learned behavior. Oh no, this is my job. It pays me money. I'll die if I don't do it. And that means you need to learn a new skill and you need to find a new job which is more clean, which is more pure. No, I spent 5 years earning this degree and yes, it is immoral, it is illegal, it is impure, but I am very comfortable. I am living a very prosperous life. I cannot let go of this. So go slowly. Take one step at a time. You don't have to leave your impure job immediately. Start developing your other skills, which you think will lead to pure work. Spend 2 or 3 years developing them while doing the impure job. You're stuck with it. And when you start getting opportunities of earning using your other skills or other kinds of jobs, slowly shift to the new one and slowly get out of the old one. Give it some time. Depends on the people. Sometimes the person realizes that I'm in a bad job and leaves it immediately. Probably he has a lot of savings already. Probably he has rich parents or who knows what. Married to a rich person. And then you can afford to leave it today. It does not matter how high that post is. It does not matter how much money you are earning. If it is not giving you peace of mind, if it fills you with guilt and fear, and it is going to cause a lot of mental diseases in you if you are in a impure job. As soon as you leave it, you do something else, you will find that the happiness returns in your life. Even if you are earning only half of what you are earning, you will be happy. Your happiness will be 10 times. That will be your earning. Now you're not loaded with this burden that I'm doing something wrong. I'm fooling people. I'm robbing people. I'm harming environment. I'm polluting an environment. I'm helping military. I'm helping politicians. I'm saving criminals from punishment. Or I'm drinking the blood of my patients in the name of treatment. I'm developing harmful software. I'm developing weapons. You will get rid of all these guilts immediately. If you find that you become jealous as soon as you see the other person, that means there is an inferiority complex there. That means you think I'm not good enough. And not only that, you think that other person should not be this good. That is the hallmark of jealousy. You are not worried about yourself. You are worried that somebody else is good. This leads to very bad behavior. Turn that opportunity into a learning opportunity. Learn from people who are more successful than you are. And you see that they are successful because they are immoral. That is also a learning. Now, why are you jealous of it? You should pity that person. Should not be jealous. Anyway, If you have your abilities, if you have your skills, whatever they are, it does not matter that you are the best. You are good enough, and that should take care of your life. And now focus on your spiritual goal. That is most important, not the others. If you find yourself competing with the others, you are going to waste most of your life doing it while gaining nothing. Competition does not give you anything. Innovation gives you everything. Just do your job. Innovate. Become better. You should compete with yourself. Be better than the person you were yesterday. That's all you need to do. Others don't matter. And if there are other people who are trying to compete with you and who are jealous of you and their behavior is causing problems to you, you know what to do. You just get out of there. Get rid of that person. You don't want unpleasantness around you. And do not manipulate people. You can ask them nicely. If you want to have sex with a girl, just simply ask her. Do not say, I love you or anything like this. Do not promise marriage. If you want a job, do not lie in the interview. Do not show a fake degree. Simply show your work that I can do this work and I'll do this for this much money. Just tell them on their face. Do not try to manipulate. Do not manipulate your relatives. Just get rid of them. If you find yourself being fake in front of people to please them or to get whatever you want, you are going to waste a lot of time and energy doing that. It takes a lot of time, money and energy to be fake. It takes nothing to be genuine. You are that which you are. It does not take effort to be genuine. And that will leave a lot of time for you for spiritual matters. You don't need to fake anything. You can live in a small house, pay a small rent, use the remaining money to be prosperous, to enjoy life. And if you need to fake to be a rich person, you will get a big house, useless house, you will pay 10 times more, and you will simply make other people jealous and negative. Remember, nobody is happy with your progress. They want their own progress. Nobody wants you to progress. Materially, spiritually, it doesn't matter. How is that I am like this? You copied it from them. Because others are faking it, you are also faking it. And that is why your life is hell. Because you are copying the residents of the hell. Live a simple, minimal life where you don't need to fake anything. Even if your behavior is not that good, don't fake a good behavior. Be whatever you are. Your purification will take care of your behavior. You don't need to fake a good behavior. That is not purification. That is fake. We should not use anybody to gain anything from them. Simply let go of the other. Oh no, no, I'll lose this thing. I'll lose that thing. I'll stop getting this thing. And that is purification. Purification is trashing things, throwing away. If you're sticking with somebody because you're getting something and you're using that person for that gain, there are very, very bad consequences of it. Very bad. You get a little bit of benefit, but then the real harm happens. Nobody likes such people who use others. You can use them once or twice, but then they come to know. If you encounter a wrong kind of person, they will ensure that they return the favor to you in least expected way. Always show your true nature to others. Don't behave in a certain way simply because they are in a certain way. Don't be conditional. Oh, you are talking nicely to me, I'll talk nicely to you. No, talk nicely to everybody. If nobody is talking nicely to you, why are you talking to them? Oh, you did this to me, I'll do that to you. No, you do good to everybody. They're taking advantage of me, and why are you with them? I already told you to trash all relations. If somebody offers you something which you have not asked, do not take it. Do not take gifts. Do not eat in others' houses. Do not go in parties. And if you go, do not eat anything there. Do not drink anything there. Go and meet people. Similarly, do not offer anything to anybody just because you need them. Taking favors and giving favors, they are same behavior. They arise from the same tendencies. Do not be guests in other families or friends. You have nothing to do, but they have their lives. They earn their money. doing very, very hard work. They're kind. They accept you as guests. That does not mean you go and sit there for a week. If you are in a high position, let us say in the government or somewhere, you will find people are ready to favor you. Whenever they come to your office, they bring gifts. I'm giving you a pen. I'm giving you this mobile phone. I'm giving you this New Year diary. Reject everything. They are actually checking whether you can be manipulated to take a bribe. If you suddenly find that a man is giving you a lot of favors, you can expect that he wants to use you. If you find that a woman is giving you a lot of favors, same thing. Do not accept anything. Reject everything kindly, gently, respectfully. If you are a really hardcore seeker, do not visit anybody's house. Do not enter houses of other people, except when it is very, very necessary. Do not drink water in other house. Those who are advanced, they will know the meaning of these instructions. Do not take money from anybody. Do not take free gifts. If somebody does something for you, pay them back more than they deserve. Do not keep anything on your side. Your account should be zero. Remember, whenever you take a favor, a deep bond is formed. You don't want that bond. How is it possible? I'm learning so much from you and then isn't that taking favor? You do not take money from me for your teachings. No, I don't. I know what happens. Therefore, all of it is free. And don't worry, it is not a favor. I'm not bonding you here. I don't have any expectation that you will do something for me. And if you feel like this, then go and distribute this knowledge to other people. That is your payback. If somebody favored you, then the rule is you return it with an interest. If they don't accept it, it's okay, it's fine. That was not a favor. And if they don't accept it because they're dead or they're not available or they want you to be in that bond, then do something good for others. Return it to somebody else. It is the same thing. We are all same. We are all connected. It goes back to the owner. Do these experiments. See what happens. You will say that I am splitting here. Yes, that's what we do on the path of knowledge. So far, your sensitivity has not increased to this level that you can see it. Once you can see it, it will become a big issue for you, your behavior with others. Because we are in a society, there will be a give and take of some kind. You cannot avoid it. And here you need to be very careful. Do not take. If you take, return it in any form. Return to the Mother Nature if you don't find anybody. This is nothing. There are people who take favors from various other entities that are highly evolved. They never return the favor. How can they? They are incapable. It has effects that last for millions of years, for hundreds of births. Therefore, on the path of knowledge, we do not worship, we do not pray, we do not ask for any favor because we know the consequences. If you are doing it, stop doing it. Oh no, I was in a bad situation and I had to ask for help. Don't worry, you take the help, you get out of the bad situation. Now there is a bond, there is a loan on you and now you must return it. Next time you find somebody in the bad situation, you help him out, that's all. Sometimes it is a simple matter of giving a lift, dropping a person to some place, offering him tea, buying a medicine for a poor fellow, that's all. There are no fixed rules here, it is all in the mind really. There are tricks to return the favors which we are not going to discuss today, but there are extremely beneficial tricks. You can say that they are occult in nature, but you are under the burden of so many favors. You don't know how many are there. There are thousands and millions. We can get rid of all of them. And now, don't be unkind. Be kind. Be compassionate towards everybody. This should reflect in your behavior also. Don't fake kindness. Don't fake manners. You need to be like that. Your being needs to be kind and that will be reflected in your behavior. Know how can I be kind that other person is torturing me? Kill that person. This is an act of kindness. Forgive. Oh no, I cannot be kind here. As soon as I become very kind and giving, everybody exploits me. Get out of that culture. Get out of that society where people are exploiting you. That is kindness. They need to get their fruit also. You become a means of giving them the fruit. You know, I was so nice to her and she dumped me. You also dump her. That is kindness, actually. You release that creature from extreme suffering. People do whatever they do because they are suffering. Otherwise, have you seen a happy person doing something bad? Have you seen a satisfied person causing harm to anybody? No. It is kindness to relieve them from their suffering. Don't fake it. If you find yourself being negative towards every situation, you start vomiting negativity. You're toxic. Wherever you go, people avoid you. They don't want to talk to you. Even if you're rich and beautiful and studded with diamonds and who knows what, they don't want to be with you. That means there is some problem in your behavior. You have a toxic behavior. Try to be positive. Try to be encouraging. There is a difference between faking it and really being it. By encouraging, I don't mean that you tell the donkey to participate in a horse race. That is not encouragement. That is faking positivity. The donkey is never going to win. Just be there. Be positive. And people will like you without you doing anything. Somebody is suffering from cancer. You go to that person. It's no problem. It's nothing at all. Don't even take medicines. Everybody gets these things. It is okay to die. This is not positivity. This is some kind of toxicity mixed with vulgarity. There is some kind of honesty in a person who is not toxic. They say whatever is needed. That is what people like about others. If you keep faking your positivity, well, nobody likes that. If somebody is behaving badly, somebody has done something which is bad, you just plainly tell them on their face if you are the affected party. And believe me, most of them will like you for that. If somebody has done something good, has achieved something, you tell them on their face that you have done a good job. Don't be negative. Don't be toxic. And you need to say only one or two words. You don't need to write a poem in their praise. That is not positivity. People really appreciate, at least those who are reasonable people, this kind of honesty, this kind of detached love that leaves no marks in the universal memory. If you change your outward behavior, you will find changes inside. If you fake your outward behavior, nothing will change inside. This needs to be understood. There has to be a desire to improve the behavior. If the desire is not there, nothing will happen. At most, there will be a fake kind of behavior which will evaporate when the conditions are wrong.